Ryan, playing your last home game, getting the last two goals. How does it feel to come out like on a high note in your career?
Yeah, it's definitely a special feeling. Like a lot of great memories on Nickerson, and this just added to it, and wouldn't want to share it with any other guys. It's an awesome experience.
Joe, another great game and goal, tying your career high in saves. So what'd you see? How are you able to kind of stop their offense from really getting an advantage?
We just played awesome, consistent defense. I think a certain plays like Malcolm getting in the hole and absolutely laying his body on the line to make the save on the long shot, and then Chase eating a shot from their fastest shooter and finishing the possession. So I think we were super tough, and they were really good off the ground, so we had to get every chance we could off the ground and get up to our offense, and we trusted them to finish, and they did.
For Joe, what was the preparation like going against an offense like Army?
Well, they have some guys that could shoot from the range, so I was working a lot with Coach Silverlick on shots right off of picks and 15 out, because a lot of those guys had 13 to 15 yard range, so I just needed to stay set. And our defense was challenging shots, which was taking speed off the shot, and I was able to read it and get some saves.
James, what did you see when coming against a defense like this?
You know, we kind of started off a little bit slow. We're just kind of, I think, we were rushing things a little bit, but, you know, the second half kind of started, we kind of got in our groove a little bit, stayed a little more patient, just looked inside a little more and finished some balls, so it's just a lot of momentum for us. Once we got it going, it was... our offense started to click.
Ryan, talk us through that last possession.
Yeah, I guess just Coach Lobo trusted me with my matchup. I was getting a shorty, so just read the defense, kind of dodged, backed out, re-dodged, and had good cutters, good motion, and just saw an opportunity and took it.
Their defense blocked a ton of shots, really shutting down your first and second kind of pass looks. How did you guys combat that while you were out there?
I think we just stayed tough off the rebounds too. You know, we hit a couple pipes, you know, they obviously got a couple of shots, but for us it's just about, you know, staying confident. When they, you know, make plays like that, it's just, you know, trying to get the rebound or, you know, just, you know, stay poised and get possession going on after that.
Joe, I know you talked about saving distance shots, but I think I counted 5 on the crease stuffs during the game. What was that like for you?
Yeah, I mean, I'm just trying to match the head of the stick inside there and hoping that I get a tip or a piece of it, but we did an awesome job of keeping the shots from outside. You know, you can think of games when we gave up a lot of goals, a lot of those are on the nest, but a lot of the ones where we won, kept it close. My defense is trusting me from outside, and it was awesome to go steal a couple of those, but be consistent from outside too.
You guys didn't have a ton of possession on offense. You know, they had the lion's share of the possession. I know it's not a stat we're keeping, but it seemed like they had like 80% of the ball a lot of the time. How did you guys mentally kind of take that challenge on when you got it?
I think we try to take every possession with attack with pace, just play our game and try to value the ball and get the best shot possible and just keep working for our best shot. So nothing really changed. We're more patient in our offense.
Anything else? Thanks, guys.